Hi guys, it's another beautiful day once again, and you are here back at Dexter's World Channel. Are going to make an update of the fish tanks that we are doing right here at our house, and you will see that we are about to complete the concreting of this tank. And this tank is intended for the filtration bucket of our bigger tank over here. So our plan is the water from there will go up here in this filtration tank, and then it goes back there already filtered, already cleaned. And I'm looking forward to planting lettuce and pechay over this tank. So you will see that this will become green and the water underneath will rise up and then flows back at the bigger tank. I can recall that this place is just the dumping site of the villagers here in our place. And I used to rent this before. This has no value before because this is immersed to water. That is why I made some effort to really own this one. And I thank God for allowing me to buy this property. And now we are able to have concrete tanks over here. Well, how many months ago I promised to myself, and even I promised to the Japanese koi that I buried just right here, that I will make a bigger tank for them. I felt guilty because I realized that they are so congested in a very small tank, just right here. And they are around 100 of them placed in this very small pen. And by the way, at the back is our tank already. It's my ritual to take a bath before placing the Japanese koi. And of course, we cannot yet place the Japanese koi over here because we have to finish this one. But allow me to just tour you to this 7 big tanks. This tank is equally divided. I put some hole over here so that the water will go there. So the flooring of this is inclined like that so that the water underneath will just go there. I'm going to put the submersible pump at the third tank, and then the water from there will go there, and then this will be filled with stones, this is going to be filled with vegetables, and then I will put a tube that the water will flow back here. So the cycle of the water is from here, down there, and then there up, and then go back here. This is going to be filled with stones and vegetables, so we will go green. And this property will be our demo farm for vegetables, for fish, and to educate people how to do about all these things. Well, I'm so glad that we already have fixed our vegetables over there. I already have made 3 harvests of this kangkong, and it's very delicious. We'll show you our selected breeder koi. These are the future breeder koi that I still have. Bigger koi that are now being taken care of by my friends, and in due time we're gonna be able to get them and put them here. But these koi are growing really fast because they are eating almost every hour. And maybe you will ask, Dexter, is it good for the koi to eat more than 3 times a day? It depends, because we can give little amount of it, and we can even give them 4, 5, 6 times a day in small amounts of food. But I would like to remind you that you have to fix our filtration system. As you can see, this box over here that is now filled with vegetables are doing really great in filtering the water. Of course, now you may ask, the water is green. Yes, because this is very exposed to sunlight, and that is why if we're gonna be able to cover a net over here, then that's the time that this green water will really turn into a crystal clear one. And my plan is to also convert this one into our spawning tank. A spawning tank in breeding Japanese koi is really also very essential because the koi will not breed in a common tank. We have to make a spawning tank, and we will fill that with plants, with clean water, and during the dawn at 4:30, as what I have demonstrated in my earlier videos, the koi will really spawn during dawn. You will note that this big tank also is filled now with swordtails and this moorfish. These are the baby moors that we had, and actually this moor has stunted growth already because they were just placed in a very small wooden tank, but now they are enjoying in this very big tank. You will see that I also have provided a filtration system for this tank, and the plants are here. But my plan really is to make this tank for our aquatic plants. And this aquatic plants also is very beautiful and also a good source of income for our business. So as soon as we're gonna finish this one, we will transfer this piece right there. And then this is gonna be fixed for our aquatic plants. I made it as temporary roofing because this roofing helps us a lot in controlling the temperature. Well, in our country, the Philippines, especially in the city of Zamboanga, is really a warm place during summer. We have to check the temperature of the water every now and then because warm temperature, too much of this warm temperature, the water will also damage the tail of our fish. So now we will go to this very beautiful and big tank. So far, this is the biggest tank I ever made. And as my way of ritual, well, I have to, please swim with me. I'm going to swim over this pen now. Well, I invited my son to swim with me, but he's too sleepy, so I will swim all by myself. The source of our water is from the well down there. We are using a deep well water, and many have asked, Dexter, can we use the water from the deep well? Yes, that's a very good source of water. But number one is you have to age this water before we gonna place our Japanese koi. Whether you are using the water from the government, the water district, or the faucet from the government, or using the water from the deep well, it is really still very important to age the water for 3, 4, 5 days and condition them, and that's the time that we gonna put the fish. So the water is here for almost 5 days already. So we will swim. Swim with me, guys. Round one. On your mark. Get set. Go. I'd like to become a fish. Maybe my ancestors are fish. Just kidding. But the tank really is good for a fish because the depth of this is around 4 feet or 3.5 feet. And then this a width of 4 feet. And then the length of this is actually more than 20 feet. One of our viewers said that this tank contains 3,300 gallons of water. And thank you for that computation. 1, 2, 3. Final round. So this is the thing that we can share so far. I hope you will continue to like and share our videos. And if you're new to our channel, please subscribe and hit that notification bell because we are regularly uploading videos and for you to be notified of our regular uploads only here at Dexter's World. Come on, let's swim!